This is a part of South Africa least touched by the passing of time. A world that existed more than 200 million years ago. It was through the study of Karoo fossils in the early years of the 20th century that scientific thought was influenced in acknowledging that mammals arose from reptiles. And as every one of us is a living fossil, containing within our genes the secrets of our ancestors, a journey into the Karoo is, in some respects, a voyage of self-discovery. A good place to start in search of prehistoric fossils is the farm Wellwood in the Graaf, Reinet district. This museum, started by Dr. Sidney Rubidge, houses some of the most valuable specimens in the world. World-famous paleontologist Dr. Robert Broom was greatly excited on seeing one specimen in particular, and that was the Milleretta. The Milleretta was the first well-preserved skull ever discovered of the group of reptiles that may have had as one of its members the ancestor of all mammal-like reptiles. To Broom, this skull was the seed of the mammal race. These prehistoric mammal-like reptiles left their mark in other ways too, such as visible footprints, found at Sante Sana, also in the Graaf, Reinet district. This trackway was made by six Dicynodonts, our earliest mammal-like reptiles, about 250 million years ago. They looked like baby hippos and trudged across the muddy plain, leaving behind their indelible print. A fascinating fossil trail has been created at the Karoo National Park near Beaufort West, where the whole story of how the Karoo rocks were formed and the fossils of some of the ancient animals of the Karoo are displayed. What is really fascinating is to think that at the time when these creatures roamed the Karoo, the continental landscape was very different. About 300 million years ago, Africa, South America, Antarctica, Australia, and India were all joined together into a single supercontinent known as Gondwanaland. Since the breakup of Gondwanaland some 150 million years ago, the Karoo rocks have been deeply eroded by rivers and streams, causing the ancient layers to become exposed on the surface, revealing the hidden fossils. People of Graaf, Reinet often refer to their town as the ancient capital of Gondwanaland, as it seems to be in the center of all this antiquity.